never been gobbled. Drove the man to the grave. Where the men for a world with a Neanderthal world. And that's how he can raise him to the grave.
Hello, guten Tag. Free gates and everything else. If you're coming, so Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. as you know, ich spreche kein Deutsch, or no, ich spreche ein bisschen Deutsch. And that even very badly. So, if you've ever seen a word in any language that's an onomatopoeic word, it's bock. It's bock. You can always bock, get that butt almost, you know. Bock. And it's kind of that little fella there, the old goat, a billy goat. One more. I get this in every one, I think, now. I don't know how to switch it off. I don't. But it's. Get on with it, Till. This is Bateman's, and they've done a few kind of smaller sort of brews and things. Some of these breweries, they do things like this. Thwaites, they've got their Crafty Dan brewery, and they do things like this. Now, Bock, it's got in there Bavarian style strong ale. Now, for a long while, I thought Bavaria was just lager. No, but there you go. Excuse me. Now, we're talking here. Got the old lens out. Originating in Einbeck, Germany, the Bavarian pronunciation of the New World famous town is Billy Goat. Maltier, stronger and darker than you dare. Think Bavaria, clinking steins, and merriment as the sees Oktoberfest now, as the perfect accompaniment to this homage to the to Doppelbock, or double bock. If you're searching for a foodie suggestion, this powerful beer has been tried and tested by a committed brewery team. I like that. And he's confirmed as pork pie and mustard friendly. Lovely. No stranger to innovation. I like this. No stranger to innovation. Bateman's has been craft brewers since 1874. And today, more committed to fresh thinking than ever before. With a wealth of good old-fashioned know-how and a healthy blend of imagination, energy and passion, Bateman's are devoted to the delivery of a true exceptional range of sovereign beers. Sovereign beers. That's what it says though. It's got little marks around it. Brewed in small batches, this eclectic extension to the Bateman's range includes Bohemian beers, world classics and limited release beers, and is very much a glimpse of things to come. Enjoy! Exclamation mark. So let's crash this open and see how we go. I do like some of the Bateman's beers. They've got some good ones. They do occasionally have ones that ain't so exciting. But, you know, there you go. A lot of breweries. I think it's the rarities when you get ones like Fuller's, say, or something like that, where you just go, every beer's a winner, you know. I think Williams Brothers is another one, and Harveston's. You just, every beer's a winner. Great stuff. So there we go. Dun, 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 dun. Bateman's. Good, honest ales. I like that. Good, honest beers. Good, honest ales. Nothing like honesty. Good, honest brewing. Now, a quick one. You're going to love this glass. If you haven't seen it already on some of my reviews, you're going to love this. There's my pint. A little pot, little thing there. Put it in your pocket. There it comes. Oh, it's in my pocket. No, it ain't. No, it won't. It'll go in pocket, but this one's too tight. I can't even get me bleeding pound coin in there. But look, no. It goes. If I can get this open. Cool, here we go. Right, like that. And then. There you go. And just pull it, give it a little bit of a pull. Just to make sure. Pull. Make sure it's all tight. I'm going to give it a wipe. Because I tried it earlier on. And I don't want to taint anything else I've got in there. I did give it a try earlier on just to make sure it worked. That's it. Right, we're ready. Bock. Oh, nice and dark. Ruby almost. Right, that'll do. I'm going to stop it there. Quite a ready ruby. Really dark. Bit of paper. Have I got a bit of paper? I've got my top of one of my GBBF bags here. I have to use that. Right, can I get a reflection? Not really. Yeah, if I tip it forward a bit and just get bits of that bag coming through. Very dark and kind of a ruby vibe there. Very kind of red. Yeah, ruby, definitely. It's actually almost purple. So that's, we're going for it there, aren't we? Right. The head has died down quite quickly. We'll give it a quick twirl around. Just to see how the head does hold on. Head got dying down quickly. Carbonation is still quite excitable. You can't see it. But it's still doing its thing. But the head dying down really quickly. What that's denoting, there's plenty of carbonation in there. Pop, pop, pop. Which will sparkle on the tongue. You can see it pop, pop, pop in at the top. But the proteins, stretchy big proteins holding onto it. There's not a lot of that going on. So I'm hoping that, this, it could be that there's no wheat in there or something like that, because people put wheat in. And sometimes wheat goes in to make the head, and it means there's not as much barley in there. It's all a balance and everything. Everyone knows what they're doing. Licorice notes. You're getting little licorice notes. Really delicate, nice kind of licorice fennel notes. Toffee. Nuts. Toasted nuts. You're getting toasted cashews, toasted sesames, toasted linseeds as well. Ooh, it's not bad. And now I've tried something lately and it worked out quite well. You take chickpeas, little bit of oil and a little bit of different salts and whatever else, and kind of roast them up in the oven. And they're like almost like I've been eating roasted cashews, but in a nicer way, and no big fats in it, because you have to hardly put any oil on. Little quick hint and tip for you there. Right, let's dive in. Cheers, everyone. Cheers. Right. 6% ABV. It's nice. It's got a bit of boisterousness to it. It's it's a nice kind of sweet sort of bit background edges, malty background edges. There's a kind of dry and funny little oily coating to it. And it's not really inspiring me. Kind of, it's, you know, it's like, it's nice, you know. It's nice. It's certainly a try it, buy it and like it. Dun 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 dun. Try it, buy it and like it. But try it, buy it and kind of get inspired by it. Sorry, it's one of the bags that come in. Try it, buy it and get excited at all. I just had a different, completely different category. Completely different category of beer, but I just had one of these, 37p a can, and that was quite nice. It was like inspiring almost, you know, and that was quite a nice thing, certainly for 27p a can. Yeah, I mean, less than half the kind of alcohol and everything, so if you're after getting on it, you're barking up the wrong tree with that one. But the Bock there, it's nice. It's nice enough, and it's nice, and it's lovely, and it's got, you know, toffee edges and things, and it's a nice beer. It is a nice beer. Does it kind of make me want to sing? Does it make me like, ooh, it's so exciting and all that? Not really. Yeah, it's doing what it says on the bottle. It's not exciting. But there you go. I mean, some other people may find it really fantastic. It's not, doesn't seem to hold complexities enough to be inspirational. And it's kind of just falling on different parts. It's a nice beer, really nice beer. And there you go. You know, it's a nice beer. So, cheers, bombs up, chin chin. Definitely try and buy it though. Try and buy it and like it. You will like it. But will it make you, will it broaden your horizons? Will it kind of make you little tendrils of your imagination stretch out beyond the nutshell? I don't think so. Cheers everyone. Little black pepper edges, by the way. Cheers everyone. Chin chin. Bottoms up. Diddly-boo. Bye. For the band to wait, with me.